We are less than 3 weeks away now from Star Wars Hunters. It is getting closer and closer, and it feels amazing to finally have an actual launch date after all this time. But what I wanted to talk about today is the fact that some of you guys may already be able to play the game today, and therefore you can actually get a bit of a head start on the competition by grinding some levels, getting used to the game, and overall just preparing for global launch on June 4th. So firstly, I'm going to walk you guys through essentially the criteria of what you'll need to do if you want to be able to play the soft launch version of the game. Then I will also give a few quick tips on what you should focus on in the game itself once you do get the game, because there are definitely a few tips I'm going to give that will really help out a lot with sort of preparing for that official launch date. Now, in terms of what you need to know for the actual soft launch, officially the game is currently in soft launch and has been for quite a while now in India, the Philippines, Malaysia, Indonesia, Brazil, Mexico, Austria, Australia, New Zealand, Norway, Finland, Denmark, Sweden, Italy, and France. Now, if you live in one of the countries that I just named, it is literally as simple as just go to your app store, whether you're on iOS or on any Android phone, and simply search Star Wars Hunters and it should come up in the official app store. So that is literally all you need to know if you are from one of those countries, and it is genuinely as simple as that. Now, obviously not all of you are going to be from those countries, and so we will still get to how you can play if you're not in one of those countries. You don't have to be from those countries. There are some little loopholes and workarounds that you can get to. For example, before the soft launch happened in Australia, because it wasn't there initially, I was still actually playing the game all the way back in November of 2021. So there are still workarounds, but like I said, if you are in any of those countries, then it is pretty much officially out right now. Keep in mind, it isn't available on the Switch yet though. It is only on mobile devices right now. So even if you're in one of those countries, it isn't available on the Switch, unfortunately. Now, in terms of what is compatible, this right here, which I'm gonna quickly scroll through, is the list of compatible devices that are currently supported right now for the soft launch. I'm gonna just quickly scroll through it, but there is the link in the description if you guys wanna see the full list, or obviously you can feel free to pause throughout the video and just see if your phone is listed here. It's pretty much that column on the second from the right there that says the actual names of the devices. And essentially, if you can see your phone listed in this video here, then it should be compatible and therefore you should be able to play the game on that phone. Now, if it is on this list, like I said, it will work without even being in one of the countries that I listed earlier on, at least on Android. I don't think you can really do a workaround for this on iOS. You may be able to, but I haven't really looked into that too much because I have an Android. And I know that with Apple, they're a little bit stricter with stuff like that. It's a bit harder to get the APKs and stuff like that. So you may have to wait for the official launch if you're on iOS, but if you're on Android and you have a compatible device, you can get the game right now, even if you're not in one of those countries. If you want to do that and you aren't in one of those official soft launch countries, I'll put another link in the description that will take you to essentially a fan run Discord server of Star Wars Hunters. And in there, they'll have all the links you need to be able to download the game. And that community will help you guys out heaps when it comes to installing the game. So if you have any issues or you're not too sure how to do it, literally just leave a message in the Discord and someone will definitely help you out. They're all really helpful in that server. Now, like I mentioned earlier though, the game is actually available on PC as well. And I think this is technically the easiest way to get it. So if you have a laptop or a PC, then this is definitely the easier way, because like I said, there are some devices that aren't compatible. So even if you're in a soft launch country, you may not actually be able to play. However, on PC, essentially any PC is gonna be able to run Star Wars Hunters. So once again, the link that I just mentioned for that Discord server, there is a channel in there that is literally just called Download and Install that has the links for both the PC and the mobile versions. So again, just head into there. You'll just pretty much need to download BlueStacks, which is a mobile emulation program. I'm sure you guys have probably heard of that before. And like I said, if you're not in one of the actual soft launch countries, you can pretty much just use a VPN to bypass the region lock, and therefore, yeah, even if you're in America, for example, you can still play Star Wars Hunters right now. It is just a little bit more annoying that you've got to kind of do these workarounds, but it is still very viable. I played the game for about 18 months there without it actually being out in Australia. So it is very much doable. And like I said, if you need anything, just head through that Discord server, leave a message in the general chat and people will definitely help you out. So that is realistically all you need to know about getting the game early. If you guys have a compatible device that I showed before, and again, I'll leave the link to that in the description as well, and if you are in the soft launch regions, or even if you're not, you are able to download the game. As far as I'm aware, the only way you guys can't really play the game yet is if you are on iOS and you're not in one of those regions. Even then, like I said, if you've got a laptop or anything, you can literally play it on PC. So hopefully that helps you guys out. If it does, be sure to hit that subscribe button and turn on those notifications, because there is plenty more Hunters content on the way. Now, with that being said, I've also got a few tips that I want to go through as well that will have you guys very much prepared for the official launch. Now, the main tip that I want to give is, if you guys are able to play the game early, it is essentially just that you want to grind as much as you can for what is called the Hunter Fame Grants. Now, Hunter Fame is essentially just XP for the individual hunters, and so a fame grant is essentially just a bunch of XP that you can then store and then use on any hunter that you want at any given time, which is definitely very handy, especially when it comes to there being new hunters. For example, Arantal at launch, he is going to be in the game and he hasn't been in the soft launch, so even for myself, who is max level, my Arantal will be level 0 when the game actually launches. Now, how the Hunter Fame works in this game is, it's pretty similar to, you know, most other shooters out there. Think of any shooter where the gun you use, you will earn XP for that gun. It's pretty much the same as this for the hunters. So if you play as Reeve, you will gain Hunter Fame for Reeve, not just for any other hunter. And so it's the type of level up system you would pretty much expect, where essentially the character you're playing as is the character you are leveling up. But that is where the fame grants come in, because you can play a game as Reeve, you can finish some challenges that will give you a fame grant that might give you, for example, 2000 Hunter Fame, which is essentially 2000 XP. And you can choose to either use that straight away or you can just store it. So for example, I've got about 20,000 Hunter Fame just sitting there. And the good thing about the Hunter Fame is that even if, like I said, I've unlocked that playing as Reeve, I can just store that and then I can use it on literally any other hunter, even a hunter that I've maybe never once even played. So they could be level 0 and I could continue to never ever play them, but I can actually level them up with that fame grant. So this is going to be really useful for some of you guys who, for example, even if you've been playing the game for a little while, for example, myself, like I said, I'm level 50, but I've been saving all of my fame grants because instead of leveling up the hunters that are currently in the game, I am kind of waiting for Arantal, and I believe Chaos potentially could be launching with the game as well, who is a KX series droid. And so the main tip that I want to give you guys is essentially to save those fame grants, because in my opinion, it's worth saving them for the newer hunters, especially the more that you've played. You're obviously going to level up the hunters that are currently in the game anyway, and then when the likes of Arantal actually launch, on day one, you could literally get them to like level 5 or 6 almost instantly just by using your fame grants. So it is definitely worth sort of grinding for them. Now, the fame grants are usually unlocked through like getting to different levels or completing different challenges or event quests. They don't usually just unlock by playing games normally. It's usually linked with some sort of challenge, but usually the challenges are pretty damn easy. Even in the actual like arena pass, there are some weekly challenges and even some tiers of the arena pass that give you fame grants as well. So yeah, the main tip I really have is just to sort of keep on the lookout for those fame grants and just save them for launch, so you can kind of max out hunters a little bit quicker. Now, that being said, hunter levels these days aren't quite as important as they used to be, so it's also not the end of the world if you don't do this and you're just kind of spending them straight away. But yeah, you do get some slight stat increases for abilities and stuff as you level up, so it is definitely still worth doing this, in my opinion. Outside of that, the only other tip that I have is to pretty much just give each hunter a proper go and see which ones you like the most. It will help a lot before launch to be able to sort of nail down who you want to main. Obviously, all the players who are playing for the very first time on the global launch day, they're all going to have to test out all of these new hunters as they're actually playing proper matches in the official launch of the game. Whereas, for example, us who have been playing for a while, I don't need to figure out who are the hunters that I like. I already know who I want to main, and it means I can kind of use them straight away, which should mean that early on in the game, I should be able to do a lot better, considering I don't have to sort of figure the game out as I go. Now, with that too, I do also have a video coming out in just over a week from now, actually, that is going to be breaking down every single hunter and what they do. So all of their abilities, their ultimate ability, essentially just what their playstyle is and stuff like that. So keep your eyes peeled for that too. That'll give you guys a good breakdown, whether you take the advice in this video and get the game early, or even if you just wait for the official launch. Hopefully that video will help you guys out. But that is going to do it for today's video. Hopefully that helps you guys getting the game early, as I know a lot of you guys are very keen to play this game. Like I said, keep your eyes peeled for plenty more Star Wars Hunters content. There is so much more on the way. But with that being said, thank you all very much for watching. You guys have a great day, and may the Force be with you always.